Is the spokesperson of government's controversial anti-communist task force facing complaints for red tagging before the office of the ombudsman. Sandro Ochona now joins us with that story. Sandro, go ahead.
Kamina, several groups have joined forces. NTFL-CAC spokesperson and PCOO Under Secretary Lorraine Badoy to be suspended until the end of President Rodrigo Duterte's term on June 30, 2022. Two complaints were filed on Wednesday before the Office of the Ombudsman by groups which included the youth, teachers, former Kabataan Party List Representative Mong Palatino, and Delphine Castro Jr., the brother of detained Natividad Castro. The complaints stem from two statements posted by Badoy, red-tagging Titi Leni Robredo and other groups. Castro insisted how dangerous red-tagging is and how it has paved the way for his sister's arrest in February this year. Palatino even asked why there is a seemingly trend of red-tagging after a huge campaign rally by VP Robredo, who is running for the highest position in the land. Gertrudis Libang, chairperson of Gabriela Alliance of Filipino Women, said because of Badoy's red tagging, many of their members are either jailed or have received threats. The groups insist Badoy's statements have caused undue injury to the public reputation of VP Robredo and her presidential campaign, which is a clear violation of Anti-Graft and Corrupt Practices Act. The groups also claim these statements also violate the code of conduct and ethical standards for public officials and employees, and that these are partisan political activities which is prohibited for those in government service like the undersecretary. Dean Tony Lavinia said the complaints filed today is just the first of a series of complaints that will be filed in the future against Badoy and other personalities. Palatino also said they are aware of those complaints earlier filed with the ombudsman and that they are dismayed over the ombudsman's inaction over these. Carmina?
Thanks a lot, Sandro Ochona, there joining us on the line. Take care, Sandra, and you keep safe.